Whoa, I'm a daredevil. My name's Jake the Daredevil, and I just like jumped in, skydived without a parachute, but I didn't. But boy, what a rush. A rush of what though? Well, thanks for asking. Epinephrine, or more commonly referred to as adrenaline. And if you're anything like me, you could use a little adrenaline in your life, but more importantly, in your dongs. Things that you can do online now, guys. This is what epinephrine looks like at the molecular level. Our bodies release this hormone in response to stress. More specifically, the adrenal glands release it. And we have two, each located on top of a kidney. The outer part, the adrenal cortex, produces hormones like cortisol, which helps regulate things like metabolism and blood pressure. It is essential to life, but the adrenal medulla is not. That is the inner part that secretes adrenaline. If you've ever been under even mild stress, you know the feeling of this hormonal release. Increased heart rate, flushed skin, trembling. It's something many people don't enjoy, but it's thought to be the reason animals can react so quickly in times of urgency. It triggers the fight or flight response that determines whether you will stay and deal with this, or you'll just kind of go off and live your life, maybe play some Game Boy, be safe, you know, whatever. For example, you could be like this baboon and fight for your life. Go, baboon! Do it! Kill the lions! Or you could run away, which in hindsight probably would have been a good decision because there are now four lions. What are you gonna do, baboon? But flight doesn't always refer to escaping physically. It can also be in a sensory way through camouflage. So clearly adrenaline can save our lives, but what happens when we start craving it? Well, bring in an adrenaline junkie like me, just jumping off chairs, doing cool stunts. Well, adrenaline junkies are thought to have somewhat of an addiction to the hormone, and it can work a little bit like a substance addiction in the sense that to get the same high, people need to take increasingly large risks with more and more frequency. If you're not one of those people but want VR experiences of risky activity, well, good news. Here's this. YouTube has some awesome videos that can actually still make you kind of nervous. Despite these nerves, we probably won't have a fight or flight reaction, although it can be triggered by even just perceived threats like these. We probably have enough self-control to not scream from watching them.
Ah!
Sometimes you don't even have the chance to respond because things are out of your control, like skydiving. Although this seems terrifying even through a computer screen, many people report an almost blissful or peaceful feeling. Plus, you don't get that stomach drop that you experience on roller coasters and other amusement park rides, and that is because the feeling occurs when there is a change in speed. When you're about to drop from a ride, you're kind of starting at 0 miles per hour, and with skydiving, you're jumping out of a plane that was already traveling at around 100 miles per hour. You will probably reach 120 miles per hour at most if doing a typical skydive, and this website explains why. As you jump out, you accelerate up to around 120 miles per hour when air resistance equals the force of gravity and they cancel each other out. At this point, you stop accelerating and reach terminal velocity. If plummeting to Earth at 120 miles per hour is a bit, dull for you, well, take comfort in knowing that theoretically, you could plummet close to 7 times faster. Felix did just this when he jumped from a helium balloon 24 miles above the Earth's surface in 2012. He reached a top speed of 833.9 miles per hour. This made him the first human to go faster than the speed of sound in a free fall. He was able to do this because the air is thinner that high up, so drag wasn't much of a factor until he reached denser air. At that point, he would stop accelerating due to air resistance. Whether it's skydiving, free climbing, base jumping, or just presenting a bunch of dongs to people, adrenaline can help you push through. Yeah! So, put on that adrenaline face, get to checking out more dongs right here. There's also dongs down there. And the reason this video exists, I don't know what I'm doing now, maybe this is a little cool dance, is that Hannah Canetti, who's wonderful, and believe me when I say that she exists, we talk about her a lot, but I'm just dancing. We never really see her. Hannah, you wanna come over here? Wanna do some dancing? Come on, Hannah. I'll scoot over a little bit. This is Hannah Canetti. How you doing?
I'm gonna die this weekend.
She's gonna die this weekend because you are
skydiving.
Skydiving, which is why this video exists, because you were scared and you were like, adrenaline, and now here we are.
That's right.
So Hannah, I'm so out of breath. Let's do the outro together.
And as always,
thanks for watching. Where'd she go? I don't know where she went.
Get out of here.
Ah! There's a chair here.